And we welcome you to Waxhaw, North Carolina tonight for our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. It's the Marvin Ridge Mavericks taking on the Myers Park Mustangs. Little Friday night non-conference action as we take a look at these two teams. Hi, everyone. Kendall Lewis here with you on BahakelSports.com. Let's start with Myers Park, 11-4 out of the SOMAC 4A Conference. So again, this is a non-conference matchup for these two teams, with the SOMAC really good league and the Mustangs off to a 3-1 start in their respective conference this year. As we take a look at Marvin Ridge on the other side, 10-7 on the year to start things off for the Mavericks, 3-3 in their league to start playoff. And we're going to look at our starting lineups. Again, Marvin Ridge out of the Southern Carolina 4A Conference this year. Both these teams few games in, a couple of weeks into their conference seasons, and a much-needed non-conference clash here tonight with the Mavericks at 10-7 on the year. All right, you're going to get your look at the starting lineups here momentarily for these two teams. Myers Park in the charcoal unis tonight. They've got the green letters, green numbers, and green trim across the front. It's Patrick Baya who is on the bump tonight for Marvin Ridge, and leading things off, Bo Alois will lead things off for Myers Park. Alois, a senior, been a big part of the success on this Myers Park team. You look at the last few years, guy does a little bit of everything. It's been the tone setter as he takes a swing and hits this one out into deep center field. The catch made, that's Hudson Murray, who is in center field for Marvin Ridge to make the grab, one down. So Alois flies out to center field, and this will bring up William Washburn, guy that can play anywhere in the infield. Plays third base tonight for Myers Park. He's really taken that bunt away from teams this year. We mentioned 11 wins. Myers Park coming off of a victory against Hickory Ridge a couple of nights ago. Count, one ball and one strike. Baya comes set on the rubber. He'll wind and fire. And it's in there, caught strike two. Get an up-close look at Baya, who we mentioned starting on the rubber tonight. Called strike three. So a fly out and a strikeout, and he gets Washburn looking.
Now batting number 21, Edgar Johnson.
This will bring up Edgar Johnson, center fielder for the Mustangs, who leads the way, batting 345 this year. Plenty of power in the junior. As he takes a look at the first offering, it's called a strike. Baya again, back to work. You betcha. Jumps ahead in the count, 0-2. Seeing Baya really work his stuff. He's got a four-seam fastball, nice breaking ball. We just saw that on display. In there again, back-to-back K's for Baya. Three up and three down inning for the Mavericks. We'll be right back on BahakelSports.com. How about back-to-back strikeouts for Patrick Baya, the starting pitcher for the Mavericks, as we go to the bottom of the first inning here at Marvin Ridge High School on our Bahakel Sports game of the week. We'll take a look at our starting pitcher here momentarily. It's Clay Masanis who gets the start on the bump tonight for Myers Park. Masanis has been really good this year, committed to play at UNC Wilmington for the Seahawks. This is a guy that is really a three-pitch guy, possesses a two-seam, a slider, and a changeup. We mentioned Myers Park, a team that has had plenty of college prospects over the last few years. You look at Eric Ford, the head coach, who's done an incredible job with this program. Tonight you get a look at Masanis. He'll battle Lucas De La Cruz, Hudson Murray, Tyler Hine. That's 1, 2, and 3 in the Marvin Ridge order tonight. Jack Newell bat fourth for the Mavericks at second base. Drew Fletcher will hit fifth. He's the DH tonight. Drew Wheeler at third will hit sixth. The right fielder, Joe Walker, will bat seventh for Marvin Ridge. And then in the 8-9 spot, it's Bennett Holder, the left fielder, and Dean Larkin, who is catching tonight. And we'll get you Myers Park's defensive alignment here momentarily for the Mustangs. We showed you Clay Masanis, who is starting on the mound tonight for Myers Park. Lucas De La Cruz, the shortstop, will lead things off for Marvin Ridge. Here's the first offering from Masanis. It's fouled back. Lucas De La Cruz, the shortstop, at bat for Marvin Ridge. Just a sophomore is De La Cruz. Facing Clay Masanis, who he mentions the UNC Wilmington commit. Here's the 0-1. In there, called strike two. And Masanis jumps ahead, 0-2 in the count. We mentioned Masanis. He's got that two-seam fastball, three-pitch guy. And time called as De La Cruz steps out of the box. Kendall Lewis here with you. BahakelSports.com tonight. High winds. Rain showers that came through early that canceled the JV game midway through. We got this one started right on time tonight for a 7 o'clock first pitch. 1-2 pitch. And it hangs upstairs. We'll square it up. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Masanis again quickly back to work, and De La Cruz fouls it back. We'll stay even, 2 balls and 2 strikes. They've got Sam Barber behind the dish. Bo Alois is the first baseman. Max Perry at second. William Washburn at third. Evan Howard at shortstop. This one just outside. Count is full, 3 balls and 2 strikes. For Myers Park in the outfield, Price Bailey in left field. Edgar Johnson in center, and Gray Anderson is the right fielder tonight for the Mustangs. Payoff pitch for Masanis, and it's upstairs. After Masanis jumped ahead in the count, walks De La Cruz, the leadoff hitter for Marvin Ridge. That brings up Hudson Murray, the center fielder.
Now batting center fielder number 8, Hudson Murray.
Murray, just a junior, 6 foot, 165 pounds. Right-handed hitter with a runner on base. Here, bottom of the first inning. It was a 3-up and 3-down inning for the Mustangs. Get a look at Clay Masanis. One of those Division I commits on this Myers Park team. We'll talk a little bit about that as this one goes along. And time called. Infield going to gather around the mound, have a quick chat with Clay Masanis. We touched on Myers Park a little bit. Head coach Eric Ford, he's in year number 8. is a PE teacher at Myers Park High School. This is a club that in his 8 years have sent 32 kids to the college level total. Plenty of Division I kids have come through this program. And it's a guy that also was a 10-year college coach at Cal State San Bernardino, as well as the head pitching coach at Belmont Abbey in his tenure, and played professionally in the club, the Cubs organization. He told me, well, look, he's got the baseball fever, just had to stay with coaching when he left the college ranks, and has had the job at Myers Park ever since. One ball, no strikes on Hudson Murray, the center fielder. Swing and a whiff, throw down to first. After the hard cut of Murray, we'll even the count up at a ball and a strike. Throw over to first, Masanis one more time, trying to get into his groove. We mentioned he's more of a three-pitch guy. He's got that two-seam fastball. 1-1. And this one fouled off. So Masanis again ahead, 1-2. Nobody out here in the bottom of the first inning. After the walk of De La Cruz. So Masanis looks in and gets the sign from Barber. He'll come set. And backs off momentarily. This one swung late. Another foul ball. Nice battle here between Masanis and Murray in the bottom of the first inning. We mentioned sun's out now here in Waxhaw, North Carolina. We had rain come through at about 5:30. This game originally scheduled to be played yesterday. They moved it to tonight. And we got started right on time. And Masanis will throw back one more time over to Bo Aloiz. Another foul as Murray makes contact. We'll keep the count at one ball and two strikes. We mentioned Hudson Murray. Hitting second in the Mavericks order tonight. Both these teams have had a couple of injuries that they've had to mix and match their order this year. And fouled off again. Pitch count really rising through the first two hitters here in the bottom of the first inning. Throw to first, now a run down. And they've got De La Cruz in a pickle, and they'll place the tag. There's the first out here in the bottom of the first. De La Cruz got caught. And one ball and two strikes on Hudson Murray. Murray's fouled off three straight pitches. Here's the delivery from Masanis. This one driven. It's a liner out into center field, and Johnson's got a beat on it. He'll make the catch. Just like that, two down. Well, it's interesting. The wind has changed directions on us a few times since we started. It's blowing. Kind of right to left on this park is Tyler Hine, the first baseman, steps in with two outs. Little check swing. Went around anyway. We mentioned Myers Park coming off of nice victory over Hickory Ridge a couple of nights ago for their 11th win of the season. Right now, they're a top 30 team in the state, regardless of class. And this one in there, called strike three. And we'll go to the second on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week right after these messages. We go to the second inning here at Marvin Ridge High School on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. Kendall Lewis here with you. No score through the first. 4, 5, and 6 hitters due up for the Mustangs. Sam Barber, Gray Anderson, and Evan Howard. The Mustangs that are due up, and you get a look at Patrick Baya, who struck out back-to-back batters in Washburn and Johnson going back to the top half of the first. He got them both looking. He'll try to pick up where he left off. Baez Sr. at 6 feet tall.
Now batting from Myers Park, number 11, Samuel Barber.
So we mentioned Baez with that four-seam fastball and a really nice breaking pitch that we saw back in the first inning. Here's Sam Barber. The catcher steps up, pops this one up in the infield over close to the first baseline, and a catch made by Tyler Hine. One down for the Mavericks. Take a second look. I'll tell you what, those routine catches tonight could be a little bit difficult with this wind. It is picked up. We've seen it 20, 30 mile an hour at times since the storms came through. That brings up Gray Anderson, right fielder. Grounds this one to second base. Newell the glove and the flip. Two away for the Mavericks. And here comes Evan Howard, the freshman, who is uber athletic. Starting at shortstop as a ninth grader in this Myers Park program. Takes a look. This is a bouncer in the dirt. One ball and a strike. We mentioned Patrick Baya, two strikeouts back in the top half of the first inning. He'll kick and fire. Just inside. So you've got Dean Larkin tonight, who's behind the plate. Luke St. John, who is usually the starter behind the dish, is out sick for the Mavericks tonight. And this went down low. Three balls and one strike. This one grounded down the left side and foul. We were talking about Evan Howard, a freshman, who has got a bright future in this Myers Park program, a kid that you're probably going to see at the Division I level in a few years. Here comes the payoff from Baya. And just a little bit upstairs. So there's Baez's first walk of the game. And Howard will take his base here in the top of the second. Here comes Sam Bundon, guy that's battled an arm injury since his freshman year. He hits this one out into shallow left for a base hit. And there's our first hit of the game. Two-out single for Sam Bundin.
No, it's the button.
And that's going to bring up Price Bailey, who's the left fielder. Another young talent for Myers Park. I was talking with Eric Ford. He said, look, we've had a bunch of kids come through our program that have really laid the foundation. You get a second look, that breaking pitch. A bunch of kids have come through the last few years that have laid the foundation in this senior class special, but the young talent he's excited about for the years to come. Count 1-1 on Price Bailey, the left fielder. Two outs and runners at first and second. Nice pitch from Baya again as he paints the outer edge. Baya from the stretch. 1-2. This one, one hops right back to him. Baya makes the flip over to first. No runs for Myers Park. Off one hit. We're still scoreless as we go to the bottom of the second right after these messages. And we welcome you back to Marvin Ridge High School on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. No scores. We go to the bottom of the second inning here from Waxhaw, North Carolina. Clay Masanis, who walked the leadoff hitter in De La Cruz back in the first inning. They were able to get out of that frame with no runs, and of course, De La Cruz was caught stealing. Struck out Tyler Hine to end the first inning. And we talked about him being a UNC Wilmington commit, heading to play for the Seahawks in the CAA. 4, 5, and 6 due up for Marvin Ridge. This is Jack Newell, the second baseman. Drew Fletcher and Drew Wheeler are the three Mavericks that are due up here in the bottom of the second. And this is a rocket right back up the middle. And the first hit of the game for the Mavericks. So Newell, a good piece of hitting here in the bottom of the second inning. Leads things off with a single, and this will bring up the DH, Drew Fletcher, for Marvin Ridge tonight. So you'll watch Masanis work from the stretch again as he throws back to first. So Masanis steps in. Here's a throw down to first. And yeah, trying to keep a check on Jack Newell, who's got plenty of speed, the second baseman. Both these teams steal a ton of bases. That's something that's going to be fun tonight. We knew coming in as Masanis misfires inside. Two balls, no strikes. He'll throw over to first again, trying to keep a check on Newell. Fletcher, a 349 hitter, threw 43 at-bats this year for the Mavericks. takes a look. They'll throw down to first again. Fletcher, one of six guys coming into tonight for Marvin Ridge that were hitting over 300 on the year. Well, Fletcher's played in all but two games so far this year. Two balls and one strike. And he fouls this one back. It's a Marvin Ridge team. It's rich in baseball history. Think about Trey Putman, their head coach, who's in year number six, does an incredible job with this program as well. Swing and a whiff. And Masanis collects his second strikeout of the ball game. Take a look at Masanis as he blows it right past Fletcher. And this brings up the third baseman, Drew Wheeler. As Masanis will take a peek over at first again. Jack Newell's the base runner, if you weren't with us, had a leadoff single to start things here in the bottom of the second inning. Wheeler, the 270 hitter at the plate for Marvin Ridge. And Masanis misfires low. Wheeler committed to play at Kutztown University, his college baseball career. As he swings at this one, it fouls it back. Masanis fires. Wheeler lifts this one out into center field. And Edgar Johnson's there to make the grab. Two down for the Mustangs. You take a second look at, we mentioned it was going to be a little bit of a challenge tonight, especially for outfielders with that wind. So two outs, a runner at first. And here comes the right fielder, Joe Walker. And Masanis will toss it over to first again. A Walker, a 250 hitter, but a 455 on base percentage this year for Marvin Ridge. Fouls the first pitch back. Walker, part of that junior class here at Marvin Ridge. One misses inside. We'll even the count up at a ball and a strike here. Bottom of the second inning, no score between Myers Park and Marvin Ridge. A non-conference matchup tonight for these two squads. This one grounded over towards third, and Washburn gloves it, makes the throw in plenty of time, and that'll do it. For the second inning, we're scoreless here on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. We welcome you back to Marvin Ridge High School as we go to the third inning here on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. Glad to have you with us. High school baseball tonight. We've got high school baseball, softball, men's and women's lacrosse, as well as women's soccer all spring long right here on BahakelSports.com. All right, Myers Park coming to the plate. It's 9-1-2 due up for the Mustangs. Max Perry, Bo Alois, and William Washburn, the three Mustangs that are due up. Patrick Baya on the mounds for Marvin Ridge. Here tonight, we mentioned he had back-to-back strikeouts in the top of the first inning for Marvin Ridge. And Max Perry, the second baseman, will try and lead things off. He's a Division I commit to play at VMI out of the Southern Conference next year. In the ninth spot for Eric Forrest's crew. Here's the windup and the delivery from Baya. And it's fouled back to the screen. Baya gets the sign. He'll fire again. Up high. We'll even it up at a ball and a strike. Each team with just one hit through two innings. Good pitch, inner edge, call the strike. With Patrick Baya really painting those corners of the plate here. 1-2. And a bouncer in the dirt. Count squared up, two balls and two strikes. And we're full. And just downstairs. Second walk of the game for Patrick Baya. And Perry will take his base as we go back to the top of the Mustangs order. In Bo Alois. Alois has been really good at the plate this year for Myers Park. He flew out into center field to lead things off tonight for the Myers Park Mustangs. And he'll take a look at the first offering, called the strike. Well, Baya from the stretch has to watch out for Perry, who's the base runner at first. He's got 8 stolen bases on the year. And Baya makes the throw back over to first. This Myers Park team, they steal a ton of bases, we mentioned. 5 guys with 8 or more. That's close there. Perry with a lead. Here's the throw. And by ahead, 0-2. We mentioned Bo Alois hit it, fly ball out of the center field to start things off tonight. As Baya keeps a check on Perry yet again. You see it 340 over out the center field, but you've got that triple decker, if you will. And this one fouled off down the right side. It's 310 down the right field line, 320 down left, and then you get into left and right center, 368, 364, the dimensions of this park. No balls and 2 strikes on Bo Alois. Alois sends this one out to center field, and Murray's got a beat on it. Charges in to make the catch. And we'll take a second look. We mentioned that wind really blowing it. Left to right right now as Murray had to kind of glide over to make the grab, but one down for the Mavericks here in the top of the third inning. This will bring up William Washburn, who was one of the strikeout victims of Baya back in the first inning. Went down looking. We mentioned Max Perry, who was walked to start this third inning, who's the base runner at first for Myers Park, has 8 stolen bases on the year. Speedy. Runner goes. This one swung on by Washburn. Hit out into right field, and Walker makes the catch for out number 2. You really see, look at those flags, that ball blowing left to right, as you see everything kind of pushing over that way right now. 2 outs, and Edgar Johnson at the plate, who went down looking. Back in the first inning for Myers Park. Swings at the first pitch, a one-hopper to Wheeler, but then a mistake, he just slipped. We'll take another look. Well, Wheeler charged in. Kind of lost his footing there, and so runners at first and second. In the game's first error. This brings up Sam Barber to the plate. A pop up over in foul ground back in the second inning to lead things off. He was a 296 hitter coming in. This is a guy that's got 8 hits on the year, 3 RBI. He's got a man in scoring position here. Runners at first and second, 2 outs. Bouncer in the dirt, and runners will advance to second and third. Now 2 runners in scoring position for the Mustangs. Here knocking on the door with 2 outs. Here's the 1-1. And Barber connects on it, foul. They get a second look at that bouncer in the dirt from Baya that led to both runners advancing. One ball, 2 strikes on Sam Barber. Barber, this one hit deep up in the hole, throw low, it bounces, but in time. Wow. We'll take another look. De La Cruz deep in the hole on a low throw, and Hines stretches to come up with it just in time. We'll take a break on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. And we come back to you on BayHackleSports.com, our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. We're scoreless here at Marvin Ridge High School in Waxhaw, North Carolina. Mavericks and Mustangs tonight on this Friday night is... We mentioned Myers Park with runners at second and third and two outs. We're threatening. And Marvin Ridge able to fend them off there in the top half of this third as we go to the bottom of the third inning with Bennett Holder, Dean Larkin, and Lucas De La Cruz, the three Mavericks that are due up here in the third inning. And Clay Masanis on the mound tonight for Myers Park. Left fielder Bennett Holder will be at the plate. Takes a look at the first offering upstairs from Clay Masanis. So Masanis, a quick worker on the mound, back to the pitch, and it's upstairs as well. Two balls and no strikes on Bennett Holder, who's the left fielder for the Mavericks tonight. And a called strike as he comes with a fastball. Which in Masanis, his fastball will be in that 87 to 91 mile an hour range. And this one just upstairs, ball three. Well, Masanis, we've seen that two-seamer. He's got a really good slider and a changeup. And a walk to start things here in the bottom of the third inning as Holder will take his base on balls. You get a look just outside on the pitch from Masanis. Oh, in the nine spot, Dean Larkin up to the plate next, but first a throw over to first from Masanis. Mentioned Larkin, the catcher tonight for Marvin Ridge. Well, Masanis will throw over to first to check on Holder one more time. We're at the bottom of the Mavericks order here. Bottom of the third inning, no score. Marvin Ridge just one hit, but Masanis a couple of walks in this one. As it ricochets off the backstop right back to the catcher in Barber. And Holder advances to second base. First time the Mavericks have had a runner in scoring position here in this one tonight. Kendall Lewis here with you, BayHackleSports.com. As Larkin will step off. Larkin shows bunt. This one bounces fair. And Myers Park will record the out as Perry was over covering. We'll take a second look. Saw Alois playing in for the bunt. Perry was over there and steps on the bag. And now time called. Trey Putman talking with our home plate umpire tonight. He's the head coach in year number six for Marvin Ridge. Well, the count is still one ball and two strikes on Dean Larkin. Bennett Holder, the base runner at second for the Mavericks right now. And Masanis will step off. Glad to have you with us on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. Masanis delivers this one, hit deep out into right field. Gets down. It's a fair ball. Trickles all the way to the fence in right field, and it's going to score a run. Wow. And it gets out of play. How about this? For Dean Larkin and the Marvin Ridge Mavericks. Get a second look. You see it all over that right field line, just out of the diving effort of Gray Anderson. And the throw just trickled over into the dugout, so Larkin able to come in and score as well in a 2-0 ball game here as Marvin Ridge takes the lead. How about that, a triple? And then able to score off a throw and the ball that just rolled into the dugout here at Marvin Ridge High School. And we're back to the top of the Marvin Ridge order here with Lucas De La Cruz, the shortstop. And time called on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. It's again, folks, we've got plenty of high school baseball coming up, as well as softball, women's soccer going hot and heavy right now, as well as men's and women's across. We'll have high school spring sports all season long for you right here on BahakelSports.com. The 0-2 upstairs makes the count 1-2. De La Cruz was walked back in the first inning, then was caught stealing. And a bouncer will square the count up, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Two-two pitch from Masanis. Hit deep out into center field, drifting toward the warning track, but the catch made by Johnson. And we'll take a second look. Mentioned 368 right there in left center field. That one got close to the warning track here at Marvin Ridge High School. That brings up Hudson Murray, the center fielder who flew out into left field in his first plate appearance for the Mavericks back in the first. Well, Masanis delivers and it's fouled back. I mentioned Marvin Ridge, 10-7 this year. They're out of the Southern Carolina 4A. That's a really good conference and a fun conference. Over in this area with Cuthbertson, Sun Valley, Myers Park in that SOMEC 4A conference, which always seems to produce teams that make deep runs. 2-1. Swung on, lifted, drifting right center. And Anderson's got a beat on it. He'll make the catch. So back-to-back flyouts here. Two away for the Mustangs. And Tyler Hine, the first baseman, back to the plate, who is one of the two strikeout victims of Clay Masanis in this game, as he takes a look at the first pitch just outside for a ball. That one's in there, call the strike. Hind, big cut, and he comes up empty. Hind, just a junior, he can also pitch for this Mavericks team. Swings late, makes contact, and fouls it back. One ball, two strikes. Masanis on the windup. Misfires low. And just inside, we're full again. Well, Masanis has had a couple of full count scenarios here going back to the first inning. Payoff, you betcha. Called strike three. And the third K of the night for Clay Masanis, the UNC Wilmington commit. We'll be right back on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week after these messages. We welcome you back in as we go to the fourth inning on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week tonight. Friday night high school baseball here between the Myers Park Mustangs and the Marvin Ridge Mavericks. Mavericks put two runs on the board there in the bottom of the second inning. To that RBI triple we saw from Dean Larkin, who is the starting catcher for Marvin Ridge tonight. He was able to come in and score as well. One ball and a strike on Gray Anderson. This is 5, 6, and 7 in the Mustangs order. Anderson, Evan Howard, and Sam Bundon, the three Mustangs that are due up here in the top of the fourth. And Anderson hits this one back up the middle for a base knock. Just the second hit of the game for the Mustangs. But a leadoff single for Anderson, who's 1-for-2 on the night. And Evan Howard back to the plate. He was walked back in the second inning and left stranded. Go back to that second inning. The Mustangs had runners threatening it. Second and third. And Bio will throw over to first. We mentioned Myers Park steals a ton of bases. One, one. Anderson, the base runner for the Mustangs, has four stolen bases of his own. And this one gets past Tyler Hine over at first. Squirts over toward the Myers Park dugout. And Anderson will advance to second. And a 1-1 count on Evan Howard. Bio will throw over to second. Mentioned Evan Howard was walked back in the second inning. It's a guy that's got 10 RBI on the season and a man in scoring position here. Nobody out. In the top of the fourth inning. Two-one, it's fouled back, and we're square. Two balls and two strikes. Even the count up on Evan Howard. Howard swings and hits it deep down the right side and just out of play. Boy, good effort by Walker and Tyler Hine trying to close in on it. And Howard fouls it back to the screen. We mentioned Myers Park, a win over Hickory Ridge a couple of nights ago. Marvin Ridge, a loss to Huff, 9-6. And this one just draws foul down the left side. Now Howard stays alive, a couple of foul balls. And a 2-2 count here in the top of the fourth inning. Howard waits on it, drives it back up the middle. Anderson rounding third. Close play at the plate. Runner safe. Eleventh RBI of the year for Evan Howard, and we take a second look. And a collision between Larkin and Anderson as you take a look. Lost his helmet along the way. And first run of the game for the Mustangs on their third hit of the ball game tonight. You get a look at that Myers Park dugout, the Mustangs. As we mentioned, last year was a third round exit to T.C. Roberson in the 4A state playoffs. That's how their season ended.
Number 24, Sam Bundy.
Oh, Sam Bundy back to the plate for Myers Park, showing bunt lifted up in the air, but it goes back into the screen. So an RBI single for Evan Howard, who advanced to second on the throw into the plate. He's the tying run, the base runner at second base for the Mustangs. And Sam Bundon, who singled back in the second inning, is at the plate for Myers Park. Shows bunt again, pulls it back. Even the count up at a ball and a strike. Mentioned Bundon had an arm injury back in his ninth grade year that he's battled really for the last 2 years, but starting to build some confidence for this Myers Park team. One ball and two strikes. Baia takes a peek back at second. And a swing, Bundon fouls it back. He's in the DH spot tonight for Myers Park. And this one misses just a little bit low. We'll even it up at two balls and two strikes. Patrick Baia, two strikeouts, two walks for Marvin Ridge in this one tonight so far. Low and away, we're full. Bundon grounds it to the shortstop, and De La Cruz throw to first. One hops past Hine, and coming in to score and tying the game is Evan Howard. So two runs in this top of the fourth inning as we take a look. De La Cruz, a low throw. And Howard able to come in and score. We're tied at two apiece and time called here on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. And Trey Putman's going to make a change on the mound here in the top of the fourth inning. Folks, we want to remind you that tonight's Bahakel Sports Game of the Week is brought to you by Queen City Audio, Video, and Appliances, Acosta Heating, Cooling, and Electrical, and last but not least, Charlotte's hometown legal team. That's the Downer Law Firm. So a pitching change here in the top of the fourth for Marvin Ridge. As we take a look at that Evan Howard single back up the middle that scored Myers Park's first run of the game in Gray Anderson. And then the ground ball that was hit over to De La Cruz on a low throw. And for Marvin Ridge, three errors tonight here in the top of the fourth inning. So Will Estes will be the new pitcher for Marvin Ridge. This is a kid that signed to play with the Wofford Terriers in the Southern Conference next year. Now we mentioned multiple guys signed to play college baseball off of both of these teams. Estes is one of those guys. And a kid that is starting to get some confidence. He's coming off of a lower back injury and is making another appearance here for the Mavericks. Again, the Southern Conference, and just a terrific Division I baseball conference with teams like UNCG, Furman, Western Carolina, just to name a few. Estes going to play at Wofford in that conference. And Price Bailey, the left fielder, up to the plate with nobody out here in the top of the fourth inning. And first pitch from Estes is in there, called a strike. Price Bailey grounded out to the pitcher in his first plate appearance back in the second inning. Yeah, time called. It looked as if Larkin might have got the worst of that one. No balls and two strikes. Estes came in to pitch for Patrick Baia, who started for Marvin Ridge, if you're just tuning in. Tied it two apiece. Bailey hits this one over to De La Cruz. Throw over to first in time. There's the first out of the fourth inning for the Mavericks as De La Cruz plays it off to two hopper.
Now batting second baseman number 18, Max Perry. Go back.
Max Perry, who has walked to lead things off back in the third, back to the plate in the ninth spot. And this one bunted foul, but Larkin finds it. Not what the Mustangs were looking for, and two away. Take another look.
Back to the top, first baseman number 27, Bo Aloise.
So back to the top of the Mustangs order with Bo Aloise. 0 for 2 with a couple of flyouts to center field. And this one gets past the catcher, Larkin. Runner safe. And Myers Park has their first lead of the ball game. Larkin on the flip. It was close. But Bundin safe at the plate. And three runs here in the top of the fourth gives Myers Park their first lead of the game. And with two outs and a 2-0 count on Bo Aloise. Estes finds the zone. Three balls and one strike now. Low pitch. A two-out walk here in the top of the fourth. And here comes William Washburn. Well, it's interesting. Myers Park's gotten production from the middle, lower half of their order tonight. Washburn 0 for 2. He struck out looking and then flew out to right field. Hits this one to second base, and Newell gloves it and steps on the bag, and that will retire the side. Myers Park puts three runs on the board. on a couple of hits. They lead 3-2 on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. We welcome you back on BahakelSports.com on our game of the week tonight. High school baseball here in Waxhaw, North Carolina. Myers Park, three runs on two hits and an error from Marvin Ridge. They're in the top of the fourth inning. Gives the Mustangs the lead. Remember, Marvin Ridge scored their two runs of the game in the bottom of the third inning. So we go to the bottom of the fourth with Jack Newell, Drew Fletcher, and Drew Wheeler due up. This is 4, 5, and 6 in the Mavericks order. And Clay Masson is still on the mound for the Mustangs of Myers Park. This one lined out into right field. Anderson having to backtrack. He makes the catch. Get a second look. Newell with excellent contact. And Anderson takes a couple of steps back and makes the grab. One down for the Mustangs. And Drew Fletcher steps up for Marvin Ridge. Launches it high in the air, shallow right. Anderson again on the move. Glides over and makes the grab. About a couple of plays from Gray Anderson. He had to find it in the lights. Right around the right field line and two down for the Mustangs. Drew Wheeler, who flew out into center field back in the second inning, up to bat for Marvin Ridge. This one ripped. It's a liner right at Washburn, and he makes the snag. Three up and three down. Myers Park still leads 3-2, and the Mustangs coming to bat right after these messages. We welcome you back to our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. We've played four here at Marvin Ridge High School tonight. Gray Anderson, back-to-back catches out in right field for the Mustangs. How about this one? He had to find it in the lights along the right field line. And then William Washburn with the quick reflexes on the hard hit line drive from Drew Wheeler. Three up and three down inning for Marvin Ridge. And we go to the fifth inning with Edgar Johnson leading things off. Their top hitter coming into tonight's game. Sam Barber, Gray Anderson also due up. This is 3, 4, and 5 in the Mustangs order. Once again, folks, it is a non-conference matchup with these two teams. We mentioned Myers Park out of the SOMAC 4A conference. Making the trip to Waxhaw, North Carolina tonight, Marvin Ridge out of the Southern Carolina 4A. Wes Estes on the mound, who came in to pitch for Patrick Baya. Back in the fourth, misfires on the first two offerings to Edgar Johnson, who struck out looking and then reached base on an error by the third baseman in Wheeler. This time he gloves it, makes the throw. And a 5-3 put out for the Mavericks, the first out here in the fifth inning. And Barber will step up. He popped up in the infield and grounded out to the shortstop in the third inning. He's 0 for 2 tonight. Barber, one of those seniors that has really helped Coach Four lay the foundation as he falls behind 0 and 2. Destes. Swings at the 0-2, lifts it up. It's a tower in the infield, and Newell's going to make the catch. That brings up Gray Anderson, who singled back in the fourth. Came in to score the first run for Myers Park, one of three runs that the Mustangs scored back in the bottom of the fourth to take the lead. And a couple of spectacular catches out in right field back in the bottom of the fourth inning. Quickly the count 0-2 on Anderson. Estes comes set. He'll kick and fire. And just up high. We're trying to get Anderson to chase a little bit. And this one fouled back as Anderson will stay alive. Good crowd on hand tonight for this one. We mentioned it was originally scheduled to be played yesterday. Forecast had rain showers yesterday, so they moved it to tonight. We had some rain earlier. Ground ball hit right at De La Cruz. He fields it, makes the throw, and that's going to retire the top half of the fifth inning. Three up and three down. Three, no runs, no hits, no errors. It's still a 3-2 game here in Waxhaw. We welcome you back to Waxhaw, North Carolina tonight on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. It's 3-2 the score as we take a look at some earlier plays here in this one. It was a three up and three down inning for Wes Estes and the Mavericks going back to the top half of the fifth. We move to the bottom of the fifth inning here in Waxhaw, North Carolina. And Clay Masanis, who started the game, still on the mound for Myers Park. This is 7, 8, 9 due up in the Marvin Ridge order. Joe Walker, Bennett Holder, and Dean Larkin. The Mavericks that are due up here. We mentioned Marvin Ridge coming off of a 9-6 loss to Huff couple of days ago, trying to get back in the win column. Myers Park a win over Hickory Ridge. And Masanis delivers a bouncer in the dirt on the first offering to Joe Walker, who grounded out to third base in his only plate appearance so far tonight. And Clay Masanis, the UNC Wilmington commit, delivers a fastball. This one swung on and nicked foul. One one's upstairs, ball two. I was talking with Eric Ford. He said, look, we really try to simplify things for Masanis. He's got, as we mentioned, that two-seamer, the slider and the changeup. He's really a three-pitch guy, but it's worked for him here at the high school level, and he may add more to his arsenal at the college level. And ball four as he misses inside. So he walks Joe Walker to start things off here in the bottom of the fifth. And Bennett Walker to the plate. Excuse me, Bennett Holder to the plate, who was walked back in the third. And a quick word. Barber trying to calm down Masanis a little bit. He was frustrated at that leadoff walk here in the bottom of the fifth. Eric Ford is going to head out to talk as well. We mentioned this is a guy that played professionally in the Cubs organization, and this might be it. It is for Clay Masanis. We're going to have a pitching change here in the bottom of the fifth. So a good outing for Clay Masanis. So he gets a round of applause from the Myers Park crowd. And a pitching change here in the bottom of the fifth inning at Waxhaw. So John Person, who's a two-sport athlete at Myers Park, is going to come in to pitch for Clay Masanis. This is a guy that plays football for the Mustangs, talented on the gridiron as well. Coming off pitching two shutout innings. Tonight's Bahakel Sports Game of the Week, once again, folks, brought to you by Queen City Audio, Video, and Appliances, your outdoor and kitchen headquarters. Acosta Heating, Cooling, and Electrical. And last but not least, Charlotte's hometown legal team, the Downer Law Firm. So John Person in the pitch for Myers Park here in the bottom of the fifth with the Mustangs leading 3-2. We take a look at the scorecard from Clay Masanis. Tonight he finishes with three strikeouts and three walks. And Person going to get his opportunity on the mound here for Myers Park. As we mentioned, a guy that plays football for the Mustangs as well, a two-sport athlete. I was talking with Coach Eric Ford at Myers Park about it. Both these head coaches, and Trey Puntman and Eric Ford, are both big advocators for kids playing multiple sports. And something you see on both squads tonight. First pitch from Person. Wilds. And Walker takes second. Bennett Holder at the plate, the left fielder. Nobody out at the bottom of the fifth. Person takes a peek at second, delivers a called strike. We'll even the count up at a ball and a strike on Bennett Holder, who was walked back in the third inning. And time called. It's a John Person's last outing were two shutout innings for the Mustangs. So he's coming off of a high in his last time on the mound for Myers Park. He'll step off here with an even count. Holder shows bunt, but it's in there, called strike two. And Person bats off again. Keeping an eye on second base, that's Joe Walker, the base runner for the Mavericks. Misses up high through the mid of the catcher, Barber. And to the backstop is Walker takes third. Person trying to settle in here on a 2-2 count. Now on Bennett Holder and a base runner at third. Marvin Ridge threatening. Swing and a whiff. How about that on the battle back from Person? We'll take a second look. And that brings up Dean Larkin, the catcher tonight for Marvin Ridge. One out, a base runner at third. We mentioned Cole St. He swings the first offering. We mentioned Luke St. John came down with an illness last night, so he is the primary catcher for Marvin Ridge. Larkin had that RBI triple back in the third inning and scored as the ball went out of play after he reached third on a throw from right field. No balls and two strikes. Person fires. This one's lifted deep over the head of Anderson. And it's going to score Walker. Larkin with a couple of RBI tonight for the Mavericks. And we're tied at three. Just gets over the head of Anderson out in right field, who's made a couple of spectacular catches tonight for Myers Park. And just like that, we are back to the top of the Mavericks order. Here in the bottom of the fifth inning, tied at three apiece. And a balk on Person. He's going to send De La Cruz to first base. Intentionally walked. So Myers Park is going to walk De La Cruz. Now Hudson Murray's up. And Hudson Murray, who's had a couple of flyouts into center and right field tonight, back up to the plate for the Mavericks. And Person delivers on the first offering with a strike. Person jumps ahead 0-2. And fouled back up and over the backstop. One out, the base runner at second. That's Dean Larkin, who's got a couple of hits, a couple of RBI tonight for Marvin Ridge. Person takes a look back. This one swung on, lifted, straight away center, diving effort by Johnson. And this one trickling through, it got down, it's a hit. Now over in no man's land. Take a second look. Wow, Johnson made an incredible effort, had it in his glove and just kind of dropped it. Great effort from Edgar Johnson out in center, but base runners at second and third now for Marvin Ridge.
Now batting number 35, Tarhan.
And time called. So two runners in scoring position, Marvin Ridge and Myers Park all tied up at three here in the bottom of the fifth inning. And now Eric Four is going to make another change on the mound. Now we're going to see William Greenway, who's a senior for Myers Park, come in to pitch. A guy that is committed to UNCG. Another one of those Southern Conference commits. UNCG, a great baseball program year in and year out. This is a guy that will throw mid to upper 80s on his fastball and has a very, very good slider. You'll see that as well on display. Another one of those potent three-pitch guys, as we saw with Masanis, who started the game for Myers Park. William Greenway in. To pitch for Myers Park. He comes in with two outs and runners at second and third. So do or die time with Tyler Hine, the first baseman, coming up to the plate here momentarily. Folks, once again, we want to remind you that we've got plenty of high school baseball, softball, men's, women's lacrosse, and women's soccer on BayhackleSports.com all spring long. Again, part of our Game of the Week package. This is actually our first high school baseball broadcast here on this Bahakel Sports Game of the Week broadcast package, and we're glad to bring it to you tonight. Windy evening here in Waxhaw, North Carolina. We mentioned we had a little pop-up storm come up about 5:30 that put a halt to the JV game that was being played before this one. Tyler Hine coming up to bat for Marvin Ridge, who has struck out twice looking. with runners at second and third. Belts this one out into left. Diving grab. Price Bailey stretches out. And that'll end the fifth. Take a second look. Bailey makes the snag. We'll be back with a sixth after this. New pitcher in for Marvin Ridge as we go to the sixth inning, and it's Alex Sobel who is committed to play his college baseball at UC Santa Barbara. The Gauchos. We'll take a look. Let's go back to that bottom half of the fifth. We saw some good pieces of hitting by Marvin Ridge, but how about this catch from Price Bailey to end things in the bottom half of the fifth, stretching out along that left field line. And that brings us to this sixth inning. So we mentioned Alex Sobel comes in to pitch for Estes of Marvin Ridge. Third different pitcher we've seen for the Mavericks tonight. Sobel, so we mentioned another Division I commit. He's going to UC Santa Barbara in the Big West Conference next year to play his college baseball. And he will face Evan Howard, Sam Bundon, and Price Bailey. This is going to be 6, 7, and 8 due up in the Myers Park order. Here as we go to the sixth inning. Right, take a look at the scorecard. Evan Howard, he was walked in his first plate appearance, then had that RBI single back in the fourth. That was that three-run fourth inning for Myers Park. And the first pitch from Sobel is in there, called a strike. Sobel, the lefty, delivers inner edge. Jumps ahead 0-2. Sobel is 6'4", 225 pounds. He'll kick and fire. And Howard fouls it back. Sobel gets the sign just away. One ball, two strikes. Oh, nice breaking pitch from Sobel. And he collects his first strikeout. Take a second look, just painting the outer half. And he gets Howard looking. That brings up the DH, Sam Bundon, for Myers Park. He's reached base twice. He singled in the second inning. He reached base in the fourth on an error. We're leaving the count up at a ball and a strike.
Go get him, Sam.
Go, Sam.
And Bundon keeps a good eye here. This one's low. I mentioned Sobel, it's good size for Marvin Ridge. Here's the 2-2. in there, called strike three. Back-to-back K's for Alex Sobel.
Defensive changes for your Mavericks. Now playing shortstop is number two, Wes Estes. Now batting, number two, Bryce Bailey. I'm sorry, number nine, Riley Matthews.
Sobel fires low on the first pitch to Price Bailey. One ball and a strike. Bailey laces this one back up the middle. And the fourth hit of the game for Myers Park. Good piece of hitting from the left fielder, Price Bailey. We're at the bottom of the Mustangs order with Max Perry. And Sobel misses low. Hard hit ground ball at the second baseman. That's Wes Estes. Couldn't quite field it cleanly. And runners at first and second. Trying to slide to his left as you get a second look at the replay. And we're back to the top of the Myers Park order, and Bo Alois. Low pitch, throw to third. No, both runners advance to second and third. Off the pitch that was in the dirt. In there, call the strike. One, swing and a whiff. Alois empty. Got base runners at second and third base. Alois, a senior, he's got four RBI on the year. Leadoff hitter in the Myers Park order. He's been the tone setter this year. One of four Mustangs with 10 or more hits this season. 1-2 pitch, and he fouls it back. Our first Bahakel Sports baseball game of the week for the season tonight. We picked a good one. Combined six runs. Solid pitching from both sides. We've seen plays made in the outfield. One ball and two strikes on Bo Alois. Sobel misses low. Alois keeps a good eye. It's two balls and two strikes. Sobel comes set. Aloise golfs it out of the zone. Throw to first, just in time. So with runners threatening at second and third, we're still tied at three apiece here in Waxhaw. We'll be right back on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. We come back to you with Myers Park, Marvin Ridge, as we go to the bottom of the sixth inning here in Waxhaw, North Carolina. Take a look at the top half, and how about Sobel striking out his first two batters faced, and then all of a sudden, a Price Bailey single, an error, and then a pitch that was in the dirt where two runners advanced to second and third. They were threatening. And then Aloise grounds out. And we stay tied at 3-3. So on the mound, William Greenway, who came into pitch back in the fifth for Myers Park. And we've got a pinch hitter to lead things off here. For Marvin Ridge, it's Michael Gross, the junior. Greenway on the first delivery. In there, call the strike. Here's Greenway on the 0-1. Just away, squared, ball and a strike. And Gross hangs on. He'll keep a good eye. This one up high. Two balls and one strike. Square the count. Here's the 2-2. Gross grounds it, second base, throw wide, but just in time, they say. Oh, no. Wow, kind of pulled Aloise off the bag. And he is out. So one down for the Mustangs. Fletcher swings to the first pitch and grounds out to second base. That brings up Drew Wheeler. Lined out to third base. He had a shot over at William Washburn, his last time at the plate back in the fourth. Takes a look at the called strike. 0-1. On the outer half, called strike two. And Wheeler swings the bat. He'll stay alive. Mentioned Wheeler committed to play his college baseball at Kutztown next year. 0-2, swung on. Deep shot out into left, and Price Bailey makes the snag for Myers Park. We go to the seventh, all tied up at three here from Waxhaw on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. Two, three, and four due up for Myers Park as we go to the seventh inning here on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. It's William Washburn, Edgar Johnson, and Sam Barber. Kendall Lewis here with you tonight on BahakelSports.com. We saw Alex Sobel come in to pitch back in the sixth. He struck out his first two batters faced. And then Myers Park had two runners in scoring position at second and third, but a ground out ended things for the Mustangs back in that sixth inning. So we go to the seventh inning. With Sobel on the mound and William Washburn leading things off. Washburn due for a hit tonight. He is 0-3. And Myers Park trying to make it back-to-back wins this week after the win against Hickory Ridge on Wednesday. Marvin Ridge coming off of a loss to Huff. And showing bunt is Washburn as he pulls it back in time. Two balls, no strikes. Sobel delivers a called strike. Two, one, it's in there. Square it up, two balls and two strikes. Good bounce back from Sobel. You betcha. Called strike three.
Defensive changes for your Mavs. Number eight is moved to second base. Bennett Holder's moved to center. Logan now playing right field is Logan D'Amico. Now batting number 21.
So Hudson Murray is now at second base for the Mavericks here in the top of the seventh. As Johnson swings on this one right down the line and caught in right field for the second out here in the top of the seventh. Sam Barber takes a look at the first offering. Sobel's got three strikeouts since he came into pitch back in the sixth. Good. Barber, couple of pop-ups and a ground out to the shortstop has been his line tonight for the Mustangs. Here's the 2-1. Just inside. Temperatures have dropped here in Waxhaw tonight. It was, again, low to mid-60s earlier. Then we had the pop-up storm come through about 5:30. High wind speeds today as Sobel walks Barber. Here comes Gray Anderson. Two outs and a runner on first. And Sobel. Good pitch. On the first delivery to Anderson. We mentioned Myers Park, a team that before Eric Ford, the head coach, got there, who he's been there 8 years now, Mustangs were a sub-500 team for the most part. He sent 32 kids to the college level in that span. And a Myers Park team that was eliminated in the third round of the state playoffs last year. Swing and a whiff, strike three. Sobel does it again. And the Mavericks coming to bat right after this in the bottom of the seventh, tied at three apiece. We go to the bottom of the seventh inning, tied at 3-3 between Myers Park and Marvin Ridge on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. Kendall Lewis here with you on BahakelSports.com. How about Alex Sobel with his fourth strikeout in two innings of work, and Marvin Ridge with a chance to win it here in the bottom of the seventh inning. Facing William Greenway, who came in to pitch a couple of innings ago for Myers Park. It is 7, 8, and 9 that are due up for the Mavericks of Marvin Ridge. Joe Walker, Bennett Holder, and Dean Larkin. Greenway comes set. First offering to Walker is up high. And this is a bouncer in the dirt. Two balls and no strikes. Walker was walked back in the fifth. He was driven in by Dean Larkin, who is in the hole, if you will, for the Mavericks. You mentioned he's due up. And there's a fastball in there, called a strike. 3-1 on Joe Walker. And it's high, ball four. Walker will take his base to start things off here in the bottom of the seventh. So Bennett Holder will step up, but time called first. There is action over in the Myers Park bullpen area. We'll see if this is another change. Again, William Greenway came in to pitch. He's the third different pitcher we've seen for Myers Park tonight. Well, this has been a fun one here. You think about Marvin Ridge, a program that head coach Trey Putman has done a great job. I was talking with him earlier today. He's a PE teacher here at the school and has been a coach here. Started as an assistant coach going all the way back to 2007. You think of some of the runs that the Mavericks have had in baseball over the years. He's been a part of those. Really loves the school. You're talking about a guy that's in his 17th year here at Marvin Ridge High School in Waxhaw, North Carolina. Runner on first, nobody out. William Greenway on the mound, misses up high. He'll throw over to first. Again, four of his last six pitches have missed the zone. Holder shows bunt. We're leaving the count up at a ball and a strike. Greenway throws back over to first, trying to keep a check on Walker. Ball and a strike. Holder trying to bunt it. It's foul back to the screen. One and two with nobody out here in the bottom of the seventh. And again on the throw over to Alois, who's holding it first. And time called. It's William Greenway facing a little bit of adversity here in the bottom of the seventh inning. Greenway, a UNCG commit. Count still 1-2. Goes back to first again. Squared up. Wind starting to pick up here. Approaching the 2 hour, just over the 2 hour mark of this ball game. We got started right at 7 o'clock. Low throw over to first. Two-two, it's upstairs. Full count. Nobody out here in the bottom of the seventh. Greenway gets the sign. Here's the payoff. In there, called strike three. Wow. And the first out of the bottom of the seventh. Holder didn't like it, thought it was so one out now. Dean Larkin, the catcher, who's got a couple of RBI in this game with a couple of hits. And the pitch high and away from Greenway. A walk and a strikeout for William Greenway here in the bottom of the seventh. And Dean Larkin, who has been red hot at the plate, looks at that one for a called strike. Joe Walker, the base runner at first for Marvin Ridge. Swung on and empty from Larkin. Good pitch from Greenway. Will square the count up at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Greenway steps off the rubber momentarily. Kendall Lewis here with you, BayhackleSports.com. On our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. Larkin swings and misses. Greenway, a big strikeout in the second out here in the bottom of the seventh. Now you see the catcher in Barber going out to have a quick word with William Greenway. We mentioned Myers Park, 11 wins this year. They've had a good pitching rotation this year. And we go back to the top of the Mavericks order with Lucas De La Cruz. De La Cruz has been walked twice, flown out to center field. It's swung on and lifted foul way back. Greenway pitches high and away from De La Cruz, left-handed hitter for the Mavericks. Two balls and one strike. And swing and a whiff. Well, Greenway has really settled in since that leadoff walk here in the bottom of the seventh. He's had back-to-back strikeouts and a 2-2 count here on Lucas De La Cruz. Upstairs, ball three, we're full again. This one checked, foul. Back to the screen. What a breaking pitch, called strike three. Three strike K's for William Greenway. We go to extras here in Waxhaw on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week.
action baseball here tonight as we go into the top of the eighth inning. The score is tied 3-3.
We go to the eighth inning here in Waxhaw, North Carolina, on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. Marvin Ridge and Myers Park. How about William Greenway striking out three straight batters there in the bottom of the seventh inning for Myers Park? We come back with Alex Sobel of Marvin Ridge. Tell you what, you're seeing some really talented pitchers that you're going to see at the next level. Sobel is one of those, as well as we mentioned, a play at UC Santa Barbara, the Gauchos, next year. We are tied at three apiece. Evan Howard, Sam Bunden, and Price Bailey are due up.
Now batting number 23, Evan Howard.
Evan Howard was struck out looking by Sobel his last time at the plate. Howard at the first pitch lifts it deep out into left, and catch made by Bennett Holder. One down. Sam Bunden, who was also struck out by Sobel, looking for redemption here, fouls this one back. Bunden does have a hit to his name. Sends this one drifting into foul territory, and it just gets down. Wow. Close play from Walker, who nearly got to it in foul ground. Breaking pitch just upstairs. Count will stay at 1-2 on Sam Bunden. Swing and a whiff. Sobel is fifth K since he came into pitch. Take a second look at the replay. And he strikes out Bunden for the second time. Two outs with Price Bailey, the left fielder, to play. Called strike one. And Bailey takes a cut at a pitch that was low in the dirt. This one hangs up high. How about this, our first Bahakel Sports baseball game of the week of the season, and we get extras out of it. Ground ball, this one hit right at the shortstop. De La Cruz, throw in time. And Marvin Ridge going to try and win it when we come back here in the eighth inning. We'll be right back on our game of the week. We go to the bottom of the eighth inning here from Waxhaw, North Carolina, Friday night high school baseball in the Charlotte metro area on our high school game of the week package. Take another look at Alex Sobel, who collects a couple of strikeouts there and then forces the ground out. So we enter the bottom of the eighth inning. And Marvin Ridge with another chance to try and end it here. Hudson Murray, Tyler Hine, and Jack Newell. Hudson Murray singled back in the fifth. That was his last time at the plate. William Greenway coming off three straight strikeouts in the bottom of the seventh, trying to carry it over here in the eighth. Give his team another opportunity. One O's up high. Here's the 2-0. It's away for ball three. Remember, Greenway going back into that seventh inning walked Joe Walker to start. That's when he had those three straight strikeouts. Four of his first six pitches back in the seventh were balls. And there's a called strike. Three, one, it's fouled back and we're full. Greenway on the winded fire. Oh, what a pitch, called strike three. Four straight Ks going back to the seventh for William Greenway. Just a nasty pitch from the UNCG commit. Tyler Hine, the first baseman, up to the plate for the Mavericks. Bouncer in the dirt. On the first offering to Hine as he goes back to work. Same thing again. This one swung on, drifting into foul territory, and it gets down. Two balls and one strike with one out. Greenway, a bounce in the dirt.
Yeah.
3-1, swung on, and it gets down for a base knock. Good piece of hitting for Tyler Hine. One out base hit. And a base runner on for the Mavericks.
Now batting number 14, Logan D'Amico.
And Logan D'Amico is coming up. To bat for Marvin Ridge, the Wake Forest commit. We've got a pinch runner as well, Mark Arthur. Here's your first look at Logan D'Amico. We mentioned already committed to Wake as a sophomore. And this one squirts away from Barber, the catcher. So a runner in scoring position now for the Mavericks. D'Amico takes a look, call the ball. Mark Arthur's the pinch runner, the Wofford football commit for the Mavericks at second base. D'Amico swings out of his shoes and comes up empty. Two-one. And D'Amico fouls it back. Well, Logan D'Amico, 6'1 sophomore. We mentioned committed to play for the Demon Deacons already as a 10th grader. The sky's the limit for this kid over the next few years. Two balls and two strikes, one out. Here in the bottom of the eighth inning. D'Amico hits this one off the hands to third, close throw, and runner safe. Wow. We mentioned it was just kind of a off the hands with a lot of spin down the line, and D'Amico is safe at first. Runners at first and second with just one out. And here comes Drew Fletcher, the DH, who's 0 for 3 tonight. He's due for one. He's got runners at first and second, just one out. And Greenway misses low. And he delivers a called strike. I'll say Greenway had those three straight strikeouts to end the seventh to force extras. Then he struck out the first batter faced in Hudson Murray. This one grounded right back to Greenway. They go to third to get the force. Now there's two down for the Mustangs. A smart play to get the lead runner. Runner still at first and second base. And Drew Wheeler, the third baseman, up to the plate for Marvin Ridge. And Wheeler swings and fouls this one down the right side. Greenway comes off the rubber. This one swung on, lifted down the line and left. And lands in fair. Wow, they say it landed in foul ground. Let's take a second look. Just kind of drifted right back on that line. Wow, that's about as close as it gets. I think that landed fair as we got a second glance. Ground ball, this one hit to short. Throw to second is in time, and we're going to go to the ninth. More free baseball here in Wetzlar. Tied up at three apiece. We'll be right back on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. We go to the ninth inning here in Waxhaw, North Carolina, on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week with Marvin Ridge in Myers Park here on BahakelSports.com. Little controversial call here as this one was fouled down what looked to be in foul ground. The wind kind of caught it, looked as if it landed fair. It was called a foul ball, and then we had the ground out to seal things off there in the eighth. So we go to the ninth inning here at Marvin Ridge High School. Alex Sobel on the mound for the Mavericks. We'll try to finish this thing in the ninth inning. Sobel on the first pitch to Max Perry, misses low. We'll even it up at a ball and a strike. And this one grounded foul down the left side. Well, Perry reached base on an error. You look at this game tonight. Marvin Ridge has had four errors in this one. Tied three apiece. Off-speed pitch. Swung on and missed. What good pitch for Alex Sobel, who collects another strikeout. We're back to the top of the Mustangs order with Bo Alouise. A one grounded hard over at third base. And Wheeler makes the throw in plenty of time.
Now batting number 12, William Washburn.
So quickly two down here in the top of the ninth. Now William Washburn at the plate for Myers Park. And a bouncer in the dirt. One oh, you betcha. All squared up at a ball and a strike. Showing bunt. Washburn pulls it back. Marvin Ridge will go to Sun Valley next week. Then a series with Weddington to follow that. And ball four up high. Washburn will take his base. Here's Edgar Johnson. A pitch away to Johnson. Call the ball. We talked about Johnson, a part of this talented junior class for Myers Park this year. And time called is they'll go have a quick chat with Alex Sobel on the mound for Marvin Ridge. This game going just over 2.5 hours. We got started right at 7 o'clock tonight. Game that was pushed back a day, originally scheduled to be played last night. Edgar Johnson, he hasn't done a lot at the plate tonight, but he's a guy that Coach Force has really came onto the scene. Hits this one deep, out in the right. Walker sets his sights on it and makes the catch. Still tied at three. We go to the bottom of the ninth right after these messages. We come back to you on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week here from Waxhaw, North Carolina tonight. These coaches made a few pitching changes. We've seen three different arms on both teams. Riding William Greenway and then Marvin Ridge riding Alex Sobel. Well, those guys have been exceptional on the mound since they both came into pitch late. couple of Division I guys that came in to pitch. So for Marvin Ridge, it's Joe Walker, Bennett Holder, and Dean Larkin. 7, 8, and 9 due up here in the ninth inning. Kendall Lewis here with you on BayHackleSports.com. First pitch, called a strike. Back to back. Oh, 2, swing and a whiff. And Greenway gets things started here in the ninth with a strikeout. Now batting Bennett Holder as he keeps a good eye on the first pitch. One-oh delivery, hard cut. Holder comes up empty. A cold, windy night here in Waxhaw. 1-2. And Holder stays alive. He fouls it back. Holder struck out looking his last time at the plate. Puts this one in play down the third baseline. Misplayed by Washburn, and a runner aboard for the Mavericks. Get a look at the replay.
Now batter number 26, Dean Larkin.
And here comes Dean Larkin, who does have 2 RBI. With one out here in the bottom of the ninth inning. First pitch in there, called a strike. Now Greenway will check on the runner over at first. Their Holder reached on the error of William Washburn. And Greenway's done an excellent job jumping ahead in counts here. Myers Park will get 4 days off. Tuesday, they'll travel to Barry to play. They got a 3-game week next week. Barry twice, Cox Mill as well. They got 2 conference games with Barry, Tuesday and Friday, and then Cox Mill the Wednesday. non-conference game for the Mustangs. Swing and a whiff, strike three. Greenway records another K. We go to the top of the Mavs order with Lucas De La Cruz. Runner goes, low throw. And now the catcher's shaken up. That's Barber, who is doubled over for Myers Park. We'll see if we can get a second look. Eric Ford comes out.
Blue, that's ridiculous.
So a runner in scoring position for the Mavericks. One ball, no strikes on De La Cruz. So they'll send De La Cruz down to first base. Now a force at every bag. And Hudson Murray steps in with two outs. First offering from Greenway is low. Greenway will throw to second. Murray empty. Here comes the 1-1. And time called as Barber's going to go out and chat with Greenway here. Well, those two have a good connection. You've seen it on display here tonight. Here's the 1-1, upstairs.
Oh, 40 minutes.
Mine says 53, but I think it's the one where it's half of that.
Two outs, two balls, one strike. It's interesting, Murray, who's at the plate now. You've got Hein, who's in the on-deck circle that singled his last time up as Murray fouls it back. So here we go. Two and two, two outs. Swing and a miss, strike three. And Greenway fired up again. We're going to go to the 10th right after this on BayHackleSports.com. We go to the 10th inning here in Waxhaw, North Carolina. Talk about our first Bahakel Sports baseball game of the week on this package this spring. It's lived up to the hype. Did we pick a good one tonight? Tied at three as we go to the 10th. So Sam Barber, Gray Anderson, and Evan Howard all due up here in the 10th for Myers Park. Barber showing bunt, he'll pull it back. Mentioned Myers Park, team that made it to the third round last year. They were eliminated by T.C. Roberson in the third round of the 4A state playoffs. Now, both of these teams, it's interesting. It talked about Marvin Ridge in the Southern Carolina 4A, which is a really good conference. Myers Park out of that SOMAC 4A conference. And call the strike. Barber will step out. He was walked back in the seventh. Left stranded. Full count, three balls, two strikes. This one, a two-hopper to short. De La Cruz charges in. Good read and good throw for the first out here in the 10th.
Put out for Dana Cruz. Now batting number 19, Gray Anderson.
So Gray Anderson, who's 1-for-4, a couple of ground outs, a strikeout, and a single tonight. And Gray Anderson, who's made a couple of spectacular catches out in right field for Myers Park tonight, is at the plate. Sobel fires low. One O's up high. Anderson shows a bunt and then takes it. Just inside on the 3-1. Ball four. Anderson walked with one out here in the top of the 10th.
Be smart.
And now time called. Just hear that wind and that. We've had gusts tonight since the storm came through about 5:30. Windy afternoon here in Waxhaw. We're going to have a pitching change here in the 10th. So fourth different arm we've seen for Marvin Ridge in the ball game tonight. And Tyler Hine is going to step in to pitch for Marvin Ridge. Well, the junior comes on to pitch for the Mavericks of Marvin Ridge here in the top of the 10th inning. And this game got started right at 7 o'clock tonight. We are approaching that three-hour mark with these two teams on a cold and chilly evening for baseball here in Waxhaw, North Carolina. Folks, we want to remind you again, we've got more games coming up this spring on BayHackleSports.com. Plenty of high school baseball, softball, women's soccer, as well as men's and women's lacrosse right here on BayHackleSports.com. And of course, we'll have playoff coverage coming up of those sports as we get into May as well. So Evan Howard will be up to bat next for Myers Park. We had that RBI single back in the fourth tonight. Just one out, a base runner at first, and Howard at the plate with Tyler Hine, the junior, coming in to pitch here in the 10th.
Be
Ray Anderson, who's the base runner at first, has four stolen bases this year. New coming in. Both these teams really can get around the base paths, creating opportunities off those stolen bases this year. Five of the combined six runs scored in the third and fourth innings in this game. Hine throws the first. Tyler Hine, the lefty, comes set. Checked swing, he pulled it back in time. Low pitch, 3-1.
Be smart.
It's low. And a walk. So a walk before with Alex Sobel. And then Hine walks Howard. Back-to-back walks. And Sam Bundon at the plate. And time called again here on BayHackleSports.com. Kendall Lewis here with you. Tonight, our producers, Brady Pugh, Mike Moore, the rest of our fantastic BayHackle Sports production crew, we're glad you're tuned in to us tonight here from Waxhaw.
No, the producer's shoes. Yeah. We try to give it an even spread. Like, we've been from Marvin Ridge to Ball and Bat Runner here. We try to go like 1-8. Yeah, it's really
And the first pitch to Bundon misses. Things starting to get interesting here in the top of the 10th with one out. It's low. Bundon struck out his last two times at the plate. 2-0 fastball, yes. Called strike one. Runners at first and second.
25 minutes.
Mine says 25.
Here's the delivery. It's low.
Got myself 10 minutes. Rough day on the other
one. Hey, G, buddy, right here. Drive it, kid.
Yeah, me too. Light 10 on the other.
And that one's in there, called a strike. We're full. Last year, Marvin Ridge won just 11 total games. They were 11-15, already 10 wins this year. Trying to match that total tonight. Here's the payoff. And another walk. Load them up here in the top of the 10th inning. And we could see another change. We are. Wow. So back-to-back walks from Hine. Loads the bases up. Three straight when you go back to when they took Sobel off the mound. And another pitching change. Jackson Mazur, the sophomore, comes in with the bases loaded. And one out for Marvin Ridge. Mazur takes his warm-up tosses here in the top of the 10th inning. And we mentioned it, Marvin Ridge, 11 wins last year. They've got 10 already this year. They play in a loaded Southern Carolina 4A conference. We were talking about that a little bit earlier. In their league alone, they've got Weddington, they've got Cuthbertson. Cuthbertson, a team that's 17-2 on the year. One of the top teams in the state of North Carolina, regardless of the classification you look at. Jackson Mazur, the sophomore. Into pitch, bases loaded. And Price Bailey, the left fielder, coming to the plate to try and drive in a run here in the top of the 10th.
Hey, excuse me.
Bailey does have a hit to his name already tonight. He's got 3 RBI on the season. Takes a look at the first offering from Mazur. Jackson Mazur delivers again. That's in there. Called a strike. Mazur, just a 10th grader here at Marvin Ridge. Kid that's got a bright future for Trey Puntman's crew. This one, one hops, it does score a run, throw to first, just in time, two outs, exactly what Myers Park wanted to do. Price Bailey comes through. And Myers Park retakes the lead at 4-3 here in the top of the 10th. Looking for some more insurance runs, if you will, with runners at second and third. And Mazur delivers a called strike. Oh, one, it's up high. We'll square that count up at a ball and a strike. Waving swing and a miss from Perry. One, two, it's belted out into right field. Walker makes the grab. One last opportunity for Marvin Ridge. They got to make up a run here. Trailing 4-3 in the bottom of the 10th. Hudson Murray. We'll be right back on Bahakel Sports. Myers Park scores a run to take a 4-3 lead as we go to the bottom of the 10th inning here on our Bahakel Sports Game of the Week. It's taken us over 3 hours. We're still trying to decide a winner here. And Marvin Ridge coming to bat. William Greenway on the rubber for Myers Park has been really good tonight. Since he came into pitch. So it's Tyler Hein, D'Amico, and Fletcher that are the three that are due up for Marvin Ridge. On the first offering from Greenway, it's a miss. One-oh misses downstairs. We've seen Greenway do this a couple of times. 3-0 counts, one in which he battled back for a strikeout. Going back to the eighth inning. And a four-pitch walk to Tyler Hein. And here comes Logan D'Amico, the sophomore who is already committed to play at Wake Forest. Second plate appearance for Logan D'Amico. Well, Marvin Ridge tonight, as we mentioned, without Luke St. John, their starting catcher, and Nico Soule, who's a Georgia Tech commit. One pitch, swing and a whiff. This one's low in the dirt. Four-pitch walk to Tyler Hein, who's the base runner at first. Two balls and two strikes. And we're full. In there, called strike three. Wow, and he gets D'Amico looking. Get a look at the replay. D'Amico was ready to head down the first baseline. And now Myers Park, two outs away from picking up what would be their 12th win of the season. We haven't seen Nico Soule. He's the Georgia Tech commit. Pinch hitting for Drew Fletcher here with one out. And Greenway misses high and away. Misses as well. Tying run is at first base. Three straight pitches have missed the zone for Greenway. And another four-pitch walk, the second four-pitch walk from Greenway here in the 10th. So now runners at first and second here with one out in the bottom of the 10th inning. And Greenway thought it was in there. It's called the ball, just low. Drew Wheeler at the plate. Wheeler connects on this one. Deep out in the left. And the catch made by Price Bailey. Take a second look. Boy, Wheeler connected on this one. Deep out in left field near the warning track. And now Myers Park, one out away from picking up their 12th win of the season. And Joe Walker comes up to bat for Marvin Ridge. Greenway kicks and fires, you betcha. Trying to shut the door right here ahead 0-2. And outside. Trying to get Walker to chase a little bit. Two outs here in the bottom of the 10th inning. Just low, squared up, two balls and two strikes. just up high. Full count, two outs. It all comes down to this. Greenway is going to go back to second one more time. Upstairs, ball four. And we're going to load the bases up with two outs in the bottom of the 10th inning. And Bennett Holder coming to the plate. Holder swings, fouls it back. Myers Park scored their fourth run back in the top of this 10th inning to take the 4-3 lead. Here we are with the bases loaded. Two outs, Bennett Holder. And fouls it down the left side. Barber trying to frame it a little bit. It's low. One ball and two strikes. Greenway fires this one. Hit to second. Perry the flip. It took us 10 innings, and Myers Park wins it. 4-3. What a ball game here from Waxhaw tonight. Mustangs get it done, four runs. And they pick up their 12th win of the season. Now 12-4 overall for Eric Forrest's crew. It took us almost 3.5 hours to get a winner, but we've got one. And the Mustangs win it once again, 4-3, our final score. Here in this one tonight, outstanding performances from both teams. For Kendall Lewis, Brady Pugh, and the rest of our Bahakel Sports production crew, we say so long and good night from Waxhaw, North Carolina.
We've been to their football game.